Hi there, my name is Joe.
And I'm Jessica.
We are homeschooling natural living entrepreneurs.
This is a story of how we balance it all for the freedom to live our lives devoted to our family and faith.
Thanks for stopping by, subscribe, and come on in. What's going on, everybody? So today I wanted to talk to you about our reselling strategy. I realize that our strategy has changed somewhat over the last couple of months, and even over the last month, and even moving forward, we have somewhat adjusted our strategy with how things are. And I realize the great thing about reselling is that there's so many different ways to resell. There's so many different models, there's so many different items, there's so many different sourcing techniques and listing techniques. And I know we talk a lot about time, space, and money. So I'm gonna kind of talk about our strategy today based off of our time, space, and money, and how the recent changes with those things is affecting our strategy. Before we get into our strategy a little bit more, I just want to go over a couple of items that we sold yesterday. All right, yeah, yesterday, I'm shipping out today, and also a couple items that we sold yesterday on Facebook Marketplace, because I know that some of you like to know what we sell. Not a lot of big dollar items today or yesterday. Sold this little Crawford 2-pack utility hooks, part of the Ace Hardware liquidation. Sold it for $16.99. Sold this little bike lift right here, and I say little just because these are small items. I probably say little too many times, so I'll watch that. But we ended up selling this not so little item for $21.99. It's gonna have to actually $22. It's gonna have to go priority mail. It's like $8. It's going to Illinois, which was cool. And then we sold this little Gundam model right here. It was part of the 888 lots, the toys lots, that we unboxed this last week, and we put the unboxings out. I guess one went out on Tuesday, one went out this last Saturday, but we ended up selling it for $21.99. It's first class mail, so it's gonna cost like $5 to ship. And then two items that we sold yesterday is we sold this one right here. It is the backpack, hiking backpack that you can put your kids on it. We originally got it, I guess probably 2 years ago, as part of one of the Amazon medium box truckloads that we purchased when we had the warehouse. And we kept it because at that point in time, or before that, you know, when Jessica and I got married, before we started having more kids, we used to go camping and hiking a lot. So our intention was to keep it and then go hiking with the kids, put them on our backpack, and I don't know, just life happened. We never did. We went camping, but we never brought it, so it had never been used. So I put it on Facebook Marketplace and ended up selling it for $50. And then we sold another baby gate, which wasn't a big dollar baby gate, but it was a baby gate out the door nonetheless. And we sold it for $25. So both met out when we are in public already, so we didn't have to make any special trips. We always say for Facebook Marketplace, try and get people to meet when you're already out around the errands that you already have, so that way it's not really as big of a time investment. And I realize that Facebook might not be the best place for you, depending on where you live. I know for us, we don't have a lot of flaky people. I think we've only ever been flaked out maybe once or twice ever. But most of the people here, they show up and they pay pretty good prices. So let's get on with the day. So let's talk about space first. When we started doing all the unboxing videos and we really started doing liquidation on YouTube, we sold a lot of cell phones. That's what Whitney did for us. That's what Wally did for us, is they kind of led that, we called it division, of product division of cell phones and cameras. That they did all of that by themselves. And those are really pretty small items. We were working out of the garage. We still the same setup that we have now. And when we were buying pallets, we were really only buying one pallet per week. And that's something that Jessica and I, we did for fun. We did it for YouTube because, you know, we enjoyed the unboxing process. We were able to sell a lot of items locally. So we had the space for it, right? Because we weren't selling a whole lot of liquidation, just one pallet a week that we were getting in. But when COVID-19 hit, that it really wiped out the cell phone market. We could still do cameras, but cameras, you know, they weren't selling for a whole lot. We made money because we had a system. We had Whitney and Wally doing those things. Same thing with the cell phones. We were making a lot of money on the cell phones. They're moving quickly, but COVID-19, it wiped it out, changed the market. We can't really buy those to make a lot of money. We could buy them and make some money, but not very much money, just because of the shortage. Demand is high, which caused prices to go high. So as our model started to change, space started to become a problem, which you heard me talking about it, that we were buying more pallets. We were starting to buy 2 pallets a week, and then 3 pallets a week, and we were figuring out where to put everything, how to fit it all in the garage. We started rearranging stuff to make more space. We kind of did all those things. That was our strategy. Now, because we didn't know how long that was going to last. We thought maybe it would just last for a little while. But COVID-19 still continues. Cell phone market's still shot. So that's when we started buying a lot of smaller lots because of the space. We realized that if we want to have the same sales volume pre-COVID that we now versus what we did before COVID, that we're going to have to buy a lot of items that are small because of the space that we had, which that's when we started buying the 8-to-8 lots. We started buying the bargain hour, all those items that, you know, range in prices anywhere from $10 to $50, $100, $200 items. It just depends on the lot that you get. But we can have a lot of items with the space that we have. So I hope you can kind of see that evolution, that process of space, with having a lot of space, not a lot of space, changing the items that we source to fit the space that we have. So let's talk about the time aspect now. We designed this, or we do reselling, so that we don't have to work full-time hours. It hasn't always been that way. I used to work lots of full-time hours and, you know, overtime hours. But as the kids, we had kids and we've had more kids and they started getting older, and we have to do more homeschool and we're doing YouTube. We try to keep the amount of hours that I work in the reselling business to no more than like 20-25 hours a week. And that's really the amount of hours that I work total now. I mean, it's probably more than that with everything, with the talking about ideas and networking and all that. But as far as physically working in the business and doing YouTube videos and editing videos, it's probably about that many hours. And the reason why we have that and our strategy with all of this is that when we were buying cell phones, is that Whitney, she ran the cell phone division. Yes, I would buy them. But she would test, she would charge, she would clean, she would list, she would create drafts. And then same thing with cameras. I would source them, but then she would charge them, she would test them, she would create drafts. And that's where Wally comes in. Wally's our virtual assistant. He lives in the Philippines. He's been working for us for over a year. We've got a heart for the Philippines. Like Jessica's family, her mom's from the Philippines. Like she grew up there. She still has lots of family for the Philippines. So we have a heart for the Philippines. But Wally, he then goes in and he finishes all the drafts for us. He makes sure the description's good, the keywords are good, that the item condition is all the information, the systems that I have created, which I'll share for y'all with y'all at some point in time, that it's all in there. He does price checks, make sure that the shipping aspect is there. So I don't really have to do it. I can just look at the drafts and I can hit submit, because I just, you know, some items, you know, as we do price comps and we're doing unboxings, I kind of have an idea of like, okay, this will serve for this. So I just do a quick visual of that. And as we do this, like we've set this up now to where our business, reselling business, where we don't, like we have other people doing it. Like it creates or it cost us around $1.75 per listing in it per item. You know, some items, it's multi-quantity items, there may be 10 on one listing. It doesn't cost us $17.50 for that. It costs us really $1.75 to get the item listed and drafted. Like, that's not a lot of cost. So we build that into it, into that time aspect for it. Whereas, you know, what we tell other people with the time aspect is that if you have time, then you're able to get less per item. Like, you don't have to make as much money per item if you have more time to spend in it. But if you only have 5 hours per week, when you source, you're going to want to source items that are high dollar items that are going to make you the most amount of money possible, so that you get the money that you need. Like, if you only have 5 hours to work per week in your reselling business, then you're not gonna wanna find $10 items to sell, because after profits and after shipping and fees and everything, you may make $3 per item. Well, that's only $15. Like, who wants to get paid $15 for 10 hours worth of, or 5 hours worth of work? Nobody, right? But when you have the time aspect, you have other people doing it for you, then you don't have to worry about that as much, right? So, which goes into the money aspect, is that we haven't always had a lot of money. Like, we're getting more money now because we're focusing things differently. We've got YouTube money's coming in now. Like, YouTube is actually making money for us. For the first 2 years of YouTube, we weren't making any money. We were not making a lot of money at all, like, with YouTube. Like, we were making like a dollar an hour, if that much, because some months we'd make like $50, like $200 in a whole month, but we were spending 20 to 30 hours per week collectively doing it, because it, we knew that at some point we would start making more money with YouTube. So as our cash flow has increased, where we have a lot more money to be able to use in the reselling business, we're putting that money to work to where we can buy lots. We can buy 888 lots, spend $1,000, which on sporting goods lot that we just unboxed today, that we can spend $1,000 on it, and after it's all said and done, we feel good with making $600 profit because we unboxed it. We made a YouTube video, and then I'll come in and I'll ship the items. Whitney can ship it if she needs to. The whole listing process is done at $1.75 per item, and we're putting money to use because we can invest it. And the more money you have, the more money that you can invest, and you can put it to use. Like, a year ago, we wouldn't have bought this. We wouldn't be buying these 888 lots. We wouldn't be spending $1,000 to profit $600 when it's all said and done, because we didn't have as much money to use. So we were buying items that sold faster. So our sourcing strategy has changed. Like, if you don't have a lot of money, right, you're going to want to buy items that you can profit a good amount of, that sell faster, so that you can get your money back faster. And that's the whole thing about building a bankroll in this business, is that a lot of people think when you don't have a lot of money in reselling that you want to buy cheap items that you can sell for the most. And that's only partially true. It's actually, you want to buy items that are going to sell the fastest, because the faster an item sells, the faster that you're going to get your money back, the faster that you can reinvest that money and flip more. Like, that's how you build a bankroll. Like, that's really a big key to reselling without a lot of money, is that you're putting that money to use so that you can keep stacking that money. When you don't have a lot of money, a lot of people say, well, you know, well, I could buy this item for $5, but then it's gonna take me 3 months and sell it for 50. But you could buy an item for 15 and sell it in a few days for $30, to where you just grew your money. You're able to buy another item for $15 and snowball that way. So that's how the time, the space, and the money aspect all work. And it's how it works with our business. And it's changing, it's evolving, because all those, like, time, space, and money, that's always changing. It should always, the whole goal with all of this is, if you want to stay within a certain space, which we do, like, we don't want the extra overhead. We have a storage unit. It's only $225 a month for 750 square feet. We don't want a humongous warehouse. We don't want a brick and mortar store. We don't want all that overhead cost. So we have space that we're going to continually work in, right? But it's the time and the money that change, and you put it to use. So I hope this made sense to you guys. I feel like it will. You'll be able to pick out some good nuggets. And if you want us to help you through all of this, then join our YouTube membership group. We have two tiers that really apply to the business building aspects. We have two tiers that are really entertainment based to kind of give you more access to our lives with different things that we have. But we have two that are really designed around, you know, not telling you all of the answers, not telling you what to do, but to be there to help you process, to give you advice on what we've done, to ask questions, point of views of things that you might not have thought about, because there's power in that. So if you're interested in that, then click the join below somewhere in there, ask questions, send us an email. But I appreciate y'all. Hope that you explains things better for y'all. Until next time, peace.